Wouldn't you wish ClickUp would just be an easy to-do list and just check things off, but we are working with multiple people on multiple projects and so many things are going on. What if I would tell you that even with all the functionality, ClickUp still can be an easy to-do list and you easily can find all the tasks that you need to know about. Hi everybody, I'm Yvonne Hyman with AskEB.com and I am a business efficiency consultant for digital entrepreneurs. Now hit that subscribe button if you want to simplify your ClickUp and join the conversation right here on my YouTube channel. Now I heard you. No matter if it was in the live show, no matter if it was in my DMs or in my Discord channel, it seems that a lot of you have been struggling lately for yourself or your team to easily find your tasks. Everybody is working on big projects. So many things are going on, and subtasks and main tasks and automations and all the things. Yet people struggle with being efficient in ClickUp because there is so much going on. So how about today we look into really simplifying ClickUp and giving you the possibility to just be like, this is what I need to do today. Done. How does that sound? Sounds good? I have three different ways for you to do that. And there is a little bit of differentiation between full member as well as guests. But we'll get to that while I show you how you, no matter what your ClickUp setup is, can easily find all of your ClickUp tasks with no problem. And I might even have a bonus tip at the end. Just saying. Okay, let's do it. Now, as you can see here, I am in my live show template right now. We've talked about this in the past. And some of those tasks are assigned to me, some are not. We have a whole bunch of different folders and spaces and all the things in here. And there are so many things going on. So how can I easily see what I need? Now, tip number one, meme out. It is one of the most hidden, it's not hidden, but most people just simply don't know about it, feature right here in ClickUp. You pretty much can find that Memo button anywhere and everywhere. And the moment you hit that button, everything is just for you. What means that? What does that mean? Memo means you only see tasks assigned to you. Just you. Nobody else. Who cares what everybody else is working on? I just need to know my tasks, right? And then you easily can just sort that by due date too to get those important things up. But we don't stop there. Memo goes throughout all of ClickUp. So right now we are in that live show template. Cool, Evie. It's like, yeah, we are seeing the live shows that are assigned to you, but what about all the other stuff? This is why you need to be a full member. Guests do not have access to everything, meaning they can only see stuff that's in their spaces, in the folders they've been added to. They do not have this everything view. You as a full member have the everything view. And as you can see, we are still in the meme out. And right now, all of the tasks that are assigned to me right here in my sandbox, cool. I only see mine rather than when I turn off meme mode where there's a whole bunch of other stuff, unassigned tasks and just stuff going on. So let's go back to meme mode and let's optimize this just a little bit more. First of all, I don't want it grouped by status. I don't care. Done. Cool, fine, we have this. Now, as you can see here, it shows this because subtasks are assigned to me, even though the main task is not assigned to me. Cool, I see all the tasks, but that still doesn't tell me what the hell I actually need to get done. Sorted by your due date. And we are sorting it that way. It's all January 12th. Let's just set a due date to this so you get a better visual of what's going on. Now you see what's overdue on top and everything that's due later on is gonna be on the bottom. And now suddenly you have an easy to-do list that tells you exactly what you need to get done right here in your ClickUp. Now, don't forget to save this thing or it's gonna be gone again. So tip number one, make use of the meme out and the sorting of your due dates to have your tasks that are the closest on due date right there for you. And it's a simple task list suddenly. That easy. Now, tip number two is using custom list views. Especially when you don't necessarily just want to use the meme mode and everything view, or you want to build your own view with specific data. There's so much we can do. And it is possible not only in everything, but anywhere else. So for your full members, you can build this in the everything view, and that's where I'm going to show you. But you can build the same kind of custom view in any space level underneath or in any folder level underneath. Because this is my sandbox and we don't have too many tasks in here, let's use everything. And what we do is we set a filter in this list. We set a filter, first of all, by assignee, and the assignee is going to be me. Cool. I can add other filters. So this specifically helps you build focus-specific task lists. Do you want to just take care of all of the web design tasks that are in that web design list? What do you want to do? So there is a location filter in here, and you can specifically decide which location these tasks are in or not in. This is what we use often enough in agencies to have department-specific lists or any way of wanting to have just a specific to-do list. These filters, godsend. Only little downside, you cannot combine and or filters. So it's all going to be and filters, meaning where the assignee is me and the location is this and the status is that. We can do all of that. It cannot be and or together. So it needs to be all or and. All and. That's a mouthful. So this is the perfect way for you to build custom task lists based on the data points that you need to see. Again, tip number two, make use of custom lists. Now, tip number three, build an on fire list. An on fire list, specifically when you have fast turnaround stuff that needs to get taken care of, when you have clients that do those 911 calls, right? An on fire list will save your booty, meaning you have the on fire tasks right on top, past dues, and the coming due right underneath. You get the idea? Cool. Now, our on fire list makes use of the priority flags within ClickUp. So make sure you have them turned on in ClickUp and you are actually using them. Let's add a couple of priority flags right in here so you see what's gonna happen with all of this. And what you do is, I set up these on fire lists in the everything view, but again, you can set those up in any space, in your space level, in your folder level, wherever you want to set those up. From the standard sorting, what we're going to do is we actually going to group this by priority. Now, what this is going to do, it is going to put up tasks with urgent priority right on top. With that, everything that gets the urgent flag gets popped up right on top. It doesn't matter the due date, it doesn't matter who the assignee is, nothing matters. The only thing that matters is that urgent flag. Now, what I recommend secondary to that is sorting it by due date too, meaning we have it grouped by priority, so on fire. This is urgent priority. This needs to be taken care of. And then the due dates next to it to see right on the fly, what's the closest due? What's potentially already past due and has that priority flag? And you can just work your way down then through the urgent priority, through the high priority, through the normal priority, into the low priority, and then everything else. This only works if you are using the priority flag. Now, another way, if you are not using the priority flag, to build an on fire list with urgent is group it by your due date, meaning you are looking at things that are overdue first. So this is showing you overdue right on the top, followed. There's a lot of overdue. I have a lot of templates in here. Yes, there it is. Followed by Friday underneath. There is some upcoming potentially, if you have those again, we're just in the sandbox here, as well as done all the way on the bottom. So to recap this, there is two ways of setting up an on fire list. What I recommend is use the priority flags, but use it sparsely. The priority flag is really just there to be like, this needs to be taken care of no matter the due date, let's get this done. And what you do then is in your on fire list, and I literally call this list, I rename this up here with the fire emoji and I call it on fire, just a side tip. Then you sort this by priority and it's going to put the urgent stuff right on top. If you are not using the priority, simply group it by due date so that you have the overdue right on top and this stuff can be taken care of. Now, here is a little pro tip. I know a lot of us actually don't much use the home view simply because we are in the tasks and we are getting it done. But the home view does have a nice task list in here too, where it's cool, nothing is due today, but we do have quite some overdue done. What's done next and what's unscheduled. All of these features and all of these ways of getting a simple task list in your ClickUp and know exactly what you need to do assumes that you assign yourself and your team is assigned for this to work. Everything is based on assignees, so make sure you do that. Now, if you are struggling not only to find your own task list, but really getting your team involved in using ClickUp, I got a video right here for you that shows you how to get your team on board and using ClickUp. I'll see you over there and in the comment section. Bye, everybody.